Welcome to Grab and Go Info. Building one general topic model is not enough in some cases, especially when there are different categories with various properties and characteristics. For example, a commercial bank may be interested in topic models built for different lines of products such as credit cards, checking accounts, or student loan. A hotel chain may be interested in the topics and reviews for different locations. In this tutorial, we will talk about how to analyze topics by group using Airbnb data in Python. We will cover how to build multiple topic models by category, how to extract topics by group from one general topic model. The Python package used for the topic model is BERT topic. For more details about using this package, please check out my previous tutorials Topic Modeling with Deep Learning using Python BER topic and Hyperparameter Tuning for BERT topic model in Python. Let's get started. In step 1, we will install and import Python libraries. Firstly, let's import BERT topic. After installing the Python package, we will import the Python libraries. Pandas and NumPy are imported for data processing. We set the Pandas data frame display options to display more rows, columns, and wider column width. NLTK is for removing stop words. UMAP is for dimensionality reduction. HDBSCAN is for clustering models. Count vectorizer is for term vectorization. BER topic is for the topic modeling. The link for the code and blog post for this video is in the description. The second step is to download and read the dataset. A website called Inside Airbnb had the Airbnb data publicly available for research. We used the review data for Washington, D.C., for this analysis, but the website provides listing data from other locations around the world. Please follow these steps to download the data. 1. Go to http://insidearm.com/get-the-data. 2. Scroll down the page until you see the section called Washington, D.C., District of Columbia, United States. 3. Click the blue file name reviews.csv.gz to download the review data and click the blue file name listings.csv to download the listings data. 4. Copy the downloaded file reviews.csv.gz and listings.csv to your project folder. Note that Inside Airbnb generally provides quarterly data for the past 12 months, but users can make a data request for historical data of a longer time range if needed. Those who are using Google Colab for this analysis need to mount Google Drive to read the dataset. You can ignore the code below if you are not using Google Colab. Drive.mount is used to mount to the Google Drive so the Colab notebook can access the data on the Google Drive. os.chdir is used to change the default directory on Google Drive. I suggest setting the default directory to the project folder. pwd is used to print the current working directory. Please check out Google Colab tutorial for beginners for details about using Google Colab for data science projects. Now let's read the data into a Pandas data frame and see what the datasets look like. The review dataset has multiple columns, but we only read the listing ID and comments column because other information is not needed for this tutorial. The dataset has over 300,000 reviews. We read 10,000 reviews. We would like to use neighborhoods as groups for the topic model, so the column neighborhood and ID are read from the listings dataset. The ID in the listings dataset is the listing ID, so we can use it as the matching key to append neighborhood information to the review dataset. .info helps us to get information about the dataset. From the output, we can see that the review dataset has 10,000 records and no missing data. The columns comments and neighborhood are the object type and the data type for listing ID is int64. In step 3, we will remove the noises from the top words of the topic model. There are three types of noises that impact the topic modeling results and interpretation: stop words, persons' names, and domain-specific words. Stop words are the words that commonly appear in sentences but have no real meaning, such as the infor. Their persons' names are high-frequency words for Airbnb reviews because reviewers like to mention hosts' names in the review. Therefore, names are likely to become top words representing the topic, making interpreting the topics difficult. To remove the host names from the top keywords representing the topics, I downloaded the frequently occurring surname list from the U.S. Census Bureau. It contains the first names with a frequency of more than 100. There are two columns in the U.S. Census Bureau surnames frequency dataset. We only read the column name because only name is needed for the tutorial. After reading the names into a Pandas data frame, they are transformed from upper cases to lower cases because the topic model uses lower cases. Two name lists are created using lowercase names. One list has the names, and the other has the name plus the letter S as the element. This is because a lot of reviewers mention the host's apartment, such as Don's apartment. The word Don's becomes Don's after removing punctuation. So we need to remove the name plus the letter S from the top words as well. Each name list has 151,671 names, and the top three names with the highest frequency are Smith, Johnson, and Williams. Domain-specific words are high-frequency words related to the business. For Airbnb reviews, reviewers frequently mention the word Airbnb, apartment, time, wood, and stay. Because I am using the data for Washington, D.C., the word D.C. is a frequent word too. These domain-specific words need to be removed because they are likely to appear as top words but do not represent the topics. Removing noises is an iterative process, and we can add new words to the list if they do not provide valuable meanings and appear in the top topic words. For example, some less common names such as Natasha and Vladdy can appear as top words. The word also appears in the top words too, but does not provide valuable information about the topic, so we will remove such words. To remove the noises from the top words representing the topics, we extended the stop words with all the noise lists. After the extension, 303,530 words are excluded from the top words. In step 4, we will talk about how to process the group or category data. Firstly, let's check the number of reviews for each neighborhood using group by. Note that we are using a subset of the reviews for this tutorial, so the counts do not represent the real Airbnb review distribution in Washington, D.C. We can see that there are a total of 25 neighborhoods in the D.C. area. The neighborhood with the most reviews is Union Station, Stanton Park, Kingman Park, which has 1587 reviews. The neighborhood with the least reviews is Deanwood, Burville, Grant Park, Lincoln Heights, Fairmont Heights, which has 6 reviews. The topic modeling requires a reasonably large number of reviews to find meaningful topics, so we will remove the neighborhood with less than 100 reviews. After removing the neighborhoods with less than 100 reviews, we have 18 neighborhoods left, and they are saved in a list called Neighborhood List. We will build one topic model for each of the 18 neighborhoods using the BERT topic model with a for loop. In step 5, we will talk about how to build one BERT topic model for each group using a for loop. BERT topic model uses UMAP dimensionality reduction. BERT topic by default produces different results each time because of the stochasticity inherited from UMAP. To get reproducible topics, we need to pass a value to the random state parameter in the UMAP method. N neighbors equals 15 means that the local neighborhood size for UMAP is 15. This is the parameter that controls the local versus global structure in data. A low value forces UMAP to focus more on local structure, and may lose insights into the big picture. A high value pushes UMAP to look at the broader neighborhood, and may lose details on local structure. The default N neighbors value for UMAP is 15. N components equals 5 indicates that the target dimension from UMAP is 5. This is the dimension of data that will be passed into the clustering model. Min-dis controls how tightly UMAP is allowed to pack points together. It's the minimum distance between points in the low-dimensional space. Small values of min-dis result in clumpier embeddings, which is good for clustering. Since our goal of dimension reduction is to build clustering models, we set min-dis to 0. Large values of min-dis prevent UMAP from packing points together and preserves the broad structure of data. Metric equals cosine indicates that we will use cosine to measure the distance. Random state sets a random seed to make the UMAP results reproducible. Count vectorizer is for counting the word's frequency. Passing the extended stop words list helps us to remove noises from the top words representing each topic. In the BERT topic function, we tuned a few hyperparameters. To learn more about hyperparameter tuning, please check out my previous tutorial Hyperparameter Tuning for BERT Topic Model in Python. UMAP model takes the model for dimensionality reduction. We are using the UMAP model for this tutorial, but it can be other dimensionality reduction models such as PCA. Vectorizer model takes the term vectorization model. The extended stop words list is passed into the BERT topic model through count vectorizer. Diversity helps to remove the words with the same or similar meanings. It has a range of 0 to 1, where 0 means least diversity and 1 means most diversity. Min topic size is the minimum number of documents in a topic. Min topic size equals 20 means that a topic needs to have at least 20 reviews. Top N words equals 4 indicates that we will use the top 4 words to represent the topic. Language has English as the default. We set it to multilingual because there are multiple languages in the Airbnb reviews. Calculate probabilities equals false means that the probabilities of each document belonging to each topic are not calculated. Next, let's build a topic model for each neighborhood using a for loop. Firstly, an empty data frame called topics by group is created using pd.dataframe. This data frame will be used to save the topic model output. Then, we loop through each neighborhood in the neighborhood list. Using the neighborhood name as the filter, a new data frame called group is created. This data frame contains only the reviews for one neighborhood. Note that we need to reset the index for the data frame group, otherwise BERT topic model gives an error message. After that, we train the topic model for one neighborhood and save the topic model results in a data frame called topics DF. A new column called neighborhood is created indicating the neighborhood name for the topics. Finally, the topic modeling results for each neighborhood are appended to the data frame called topics by group. We can see that the data frame topics by group has 4 columns. The column topic has topic numbers. -1 should be ignored. It indicates that the reviews are not assigned to any specific topic. All the non-negative numbers are the topics created for the reviews. The column count has the number of reviews for each topic. The topics are ordered by the number of reviews in each topic, so topic 0 has the highest number of reviews for each neighborhood. The column name lists the top words representing each topic. The column neighborhood indicates the neighborhood group for the topic model. In step 6, we will talk about how to create one topic model for multiple groups. This helps us to understand how a topic is distributed across different groups. Firstly, an overall topic model will be created using the reviews from all the neighborhoods. Notice that the parameter min topic size equals 200 for the global model, while min topic size equals 20 for the group level model. This is because the global topic model has more reviews available. The top words representation for the global topic model are extracted and saved in a column called name in the model results. For each neighborhood, the representation of a top word is created based on the reviews for the neighborhood under each topic. This is achieved by applying the topics per class attribute on the topic model. The topics per class attribute takes in the documents and classes, where classes is for the list of groups. We can visualize topics by group using visualize topics per class. Top n topics equals 9 means that we will only visualize the top 9 topics. The visualization chart is interactive and we can add or remove global topics by clicking the topics under global topic representation. The x-axis is the review frequency and the y-axis is the list of neighborhoods. The length of the bar represents the number of reviews for the selected global topic for each group. We can see the group level topic representation by hovering the mouse over each bar. For the global topic 0, we can see that most reviews are from the neighborhood Union Station, Stanton Park, Kingman Park, and the top representation for this group is restaurants, parking, bike, and Luft. We can also compare the distribution of different global topics. For example, comparing topic 4 and topic 8 shows that topic 4 reviews are mainly from the Cathedral Heights, McLean Gardens, Glover Park neighborhood, and topic 8 reviews are mainly from the Southwest Employment Area, Southwest, Waterfront, Fort McNair, Buzzard Point neighborhood. This is as expected because topic 4 is about Cathedral and topic 8 is about Stadium. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about natural language processing, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.